Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today we're going to unbox HP Smart Tank 7301. Basically, it's a 7300 series, like a 7301-02. And we're going to unpack it and set it up, fill with the ink, and also we're going to connect to the Wi-Fi. So we get a menu and a printer, and those are printheads. One printhead is the black printhead. That takes pigment ink, and another is tricolor printheads that take a 3-dye ink. The printer comes with 135 mil of black pigment ink, and each color ink is 70 mil, and the number is 31 for the colors and 32 XL for the black. After you use up the ink, do not throw the bottles away. And if you want to replenish later and you don't want to use the expensive HP ink, you can go to bchtechnologies.com and go to ink for printers and refill for HP. You want to check a pigment dye ink. So this combo, 3PH, that's the three blacks of pigment ink and three colors dye ink. So you get a pigment ink and dye ink together as one package, and it's only $25. And then remember, the black, original black on the HP is $135. So here we got three bottles. That's $300. So it's twice the amount of the ink you got from HP 32XL. And for 31, each bottle is 100 mil, and the original one is 70 mil. So it's about 1.5 times of you get from HP. If we go to Amazon, so here the third party HP ink, one set is $27. So you'll pay me more money to get less ink. The difference is we do not put our ink in the HP bottle. We don't want to violate anybody's patent. Although our inks works for HP, the bottles cannot be directly used on the smart tanks. You have to save your old bottles from smart tanks and just use it as a funnel. Now we can remove the blue packing tapes. And there's a cardboard with the blue packing tapes once you leave the scanner. And you want to slide it out, slide to your right and remove it. And do not directly pull it upwards. Now we need to remove this cardboard box and the blue tapes from the paper tray. We can connect the power cord and turn the printer on. On the LCD screen, you're going to see a couple of ink bottle icons flashing, and it prompts you to put the ink in. Lift up the cover for the black on the left and colors on your right, and then lift up their caps. For each bottle, remember there's a protective seal on the top. You need to remove that seal. Then you can put the cap back, put the bottle upside down, find where the ink intake, and just resting there, you're going to hear the printer start drinking ink. Go do. If you do it correctly, you're going to see the ink level comes down, and you're going to see the ink level rest up on the handle on the printer. Remember, when you do this, you have to have the printer powers down. So when you close the scanner lid, you're going to see those icons. That means it's ready for the printhead. Open up the printer and press the blue button, and then you can throw this orange stuff away. The printheads are color-coded. The purple means it's a tricolor, and remove the orange cap and then tear off the tape and put it on the left. And the black is on the right side. The side with electronic ribbons towards front. Now you can close the cap and close the scanner. As soon as you close the scanner, the printer is going to ask you for some paper. And put the paper in, it's going to print a weird page. It's called alignment page. Put the page upside down on the scanner, and So the white is towards sky, the printed side is towards bottom. The printer will automatically scan it and align itself. Now we go to 123.hp.com. No matter you're using Mac or PC or you use your phone, it's the same procedure. Type in the model, click install HP Smart. Here, because I'm using a Windows 10, so it automatically brings up the Microsoft Store and just go install it. And fire it up, it has a couple of boilerplate stuff. I agree, it's going to start searching for the printer. And you're going to see it asking you to put a printer into Wi-Fi mode. And I cannot find it because you haven't put it in the Wi-Fi mode yet. Let's put the printer into Wi-Fi mode. So I'm going to walk over to the printer and press and hold the I means information button. And we're going to hold it until all the buttons light up. Now we press and hold the Wi-Fi button and the red cross cancel button together until all the buttons turn off and the power button going to flash. Now we walk back to the computer. Click try again, it should find the printer. And click continue. It's going to use your current Wi-Fi connection on your computer and use your password to contact the printer. Basically, it's writing the password to the printer. And now it asks you to press the information button. If you don't do it, or sometimes it fails, let me show you an alternative way of putting the password into the printer. Click try again, and it's going to ask you to select which Wi-Fi you're going to use, and then you can type in the password by hand. And click continue, and it should have your Wi-Fi all set up to go. Sometimes you got to go through the three stages, and it's going to hang here forever. And don't worry, the printer is already set up. The HP just trying to do extra registration stuff. You don't need it. You can say if I go to printer and scanners, and the printer is all set up, I can change in the printer preferences, everything, and the printer is ready to go. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at www.bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.